Another Halo figure here, 7 inches or 18 centimeters tall. This is the Jazzwares line or the Spartan collection that has came out. Previous release reviewed these two here on the channel, so you can check them out if you want to have a look. And we'll give you a quick comparison to them anyway. But this one here, this red one, is known as a Spartan Mark 7. With accessories, so lots and lots of different Spartans. Packaging's kind of nice, but very cheap, and it kind of feels like it pops open a little bit. It's a shame because it's kind of bordering on a kind of nice Black Series, nice NECA-like structure, but it's still a little kind of juniorish and not quite as cool as it could be. But yeah, it's not a bad line. It's still a pretty cheap line to collect if you're into 7-inch figures. Both of these reviewed. I'm going to skip this Cat B320. It just doesn't look very good to my mind, so I'm going to skip that one. UPC should you need it, and nothing else really on the box. It's pretty plain. Halo Infinite, of course, is coming out 2021, later on in the fall. If you also buy one of these figures, inside you will find a little Halo Infinite code for when the game finally comes out. And I'm not going to turn it around because there's a little promo code on the back and you can basically unlock guns, skins, whatever it may be. So, is this figure the same as a Halo repaint as I thought it was going to be? Well, no, it's not. It's actually completely different, but still very similar in style and design. Overall, it does not appear to the best I can see, use any of the parts on the other figures, which is a real plus. It's kind of cool. Maybe these little jet thruster pieces at the back. No, they're completely different too. Everything is brand spanking on this. So wow, it's pretty cool indeed. New blaster. We haven't seen this line already before. And comparing to the other previous figure there, nothing again. It's a unique helmet, unique design. Thighs, have they been reused? Nope. Shins, nope. Everything is... Maybe the toes. Nope, not even the toes. Brand new figure. So that's something kind of interesting that Jazzwares are not giving us kind of endless Master Chief repaints, which I kind of thought I expected they would have to do. Now it does come with a couple of weapons. We get this smaller weapon here, which I've plugged into the back. The weapons don't generally stay on too well, as is witnessed by my first video where I was trying to work out what these little side pieces were for. Now I did, just as the video finished, kind of put two and two when I looked at the pack shots online. So it does kind of, yeah, kind of works, but it keeps falling out, these little side pieces. And this figure is no different, although these ones are kind of really tough to get out. So yeah, they're kind of, this one's painted in, so it's kind of, or in fact, does that one come out? No, I don't think it does. So, a little bit confusing. Oh, it does, but it isn't as painted. I don't know. It's just not the clearest thing they did with these little side pieces to explain that there you go, that you can remove them. But they're kind of crap because they fall out really easily. And trying to put that lumpy surface against that inner surface, well, in this case, this one's working. But a little bit loosey-goosey, but yeah, not so bad. It can work for your figures. But now I put that back in, it'll probably... Nope, it's going to stay. This rifle is pretty cool too. Kind of plain. Not a great deal going on in it. It is that kind of slightly annoying plastic that's just way too bendy and cheap. It really should have been much more rigid plastic, I would have suggested. But it does help get the figure to hold it a little bit better without the rigidity. Is that a word? Don't know. Little peg hole there for the blaster to basically peg onto the back if you want. I've just got it holding in this kind of position here as it seems to be quite comfortable to do so. Nice little touches, the gold again here, just like Chief's up at the top on the helmet visor, and it looks pretty nice. It's different design overall. But there's some nice touches on this that they went a bit nuts with the dry brushing. You can really see the silver brushed across it, but let's be grateful at the price point in this figure that they at least applied that, because I expected and have seen, well, maybe this is a good example, this one didn't really get any at all. So some do, some don't. It did get it on the legs, it seemed to get a little bit there, but these are passable figures, they're still pretty solid. I really do like them actually, the more I'm getting into some of the designs. But yeah, it's a little on the cheap side, yeah, they could do a lot more if they just really up the quality just a little bit more, but still, they've got to make money. So nicely done. Lots of nice little touches here and there with that kind of shine. It just picks up some of the sculpt and the reflectiveness, and just adds that kind of metallicized look to the what is would be otherwise very drab plastic. And it's kind of shined back there too, which looks kind of nice. And the kind of spinal support on the underbody suit, a little bit of grey, and the helmet looks really nice from a profile side point. So I like it, digging it. I like these guys, and the way the weathering's caught the little exhaust pipes on the helmet is very, very nice. Yeah, it's very cool. Articulation's pretty fluid, no major issues at all. Head is very flexible indeed. A little bit stiff to go up and down, but again, that's not bad. For an armored figure, we're really not having any major restrictions. As you can see on the arms, a little bit weird with the joints. They've got this kind of butterfly joint. You've then got this ball joint in the shoulders, which again allows pretty damn good range of movement, actually. It looks loose, but it's actually not. It's holding itself together. We've got a bicep swivel up at the top, up there, I believe, if it even manages to go right. Yep, it does. You've then got double joints at the elbows, and down to swivels on the wrist and back and forth. You've got a reasonably rubbish, actually, ab crunch. It's in fact really non-existent. And then a swivel waist, which is really non-existent either, but it's not such a huge issue, I think, on this style of figure. It's not too bad. It's enough to get into some kind of key poses. Weird-ish kind of, well, fine, not weird at all. Standard pegs up at the top of the thighs. You've then got a thigh swivel, double joints at the knees. You've then got rocking ankles and articulated toes, which with peg holes too, kind of really huge ones actually. So for a figure line, 7-inch figure line, the stands are going to be a little bit weird. Not a lot of the ones that I've got even remotely fit that, but they tend to stand pretty well because of the huge ass, big flat feet. But they're pretty cool. I'm liking them. I am liking them. I'm looking forward to some other waves and some other chiefs and other bits and pieces, but so far they're not too shabby. Again, really good kind of looking figures. They're great for adding a little bit of paint yourself and tarting them up. Weapons, again, a little bit too spongy and soft and squidgy. Could have really done with more kind of a paint wash across all of them. A little bit more accessories. I should mention also this figure comes with the same type of hands the other ones came with. Which is nice, nice addition. We get a kind of salute at side. We've got a gripping hand, two fists, and another gripping hand. So you get plenty of options with a figure. Again, for a pretty low price point overall. I've seen these ranging anywhere from like kind of $15 US to about $28 US, and the same in different countries as well. So yeah. Pretty reasonable. Let us know what you think, and we'll see for more Halo and other figure reviews coming up.